Hello kids, in this video we are going to see the safeguarding the eggs, animal that give birth to the young ones, care of young ones. Okay, so look here, animals protect their eggs from being eaten by the other animals. They also protect their newly hatched young ones for the same reason. Animals, they lay their eggs in place where they are least likely to be eaten off by the other animals or insects. How animals protect their eggs, look here, their eggs from being eaten by other animals. Animals eat egg of the other animals. Understood, no? So animal protect the eggs by eating the other animals. They also protect their newly hatched young ones for the same reason. Newly hatched eggs, no? They eaten by other animals. Animals also lay eggs in place where they are least likely to be eaten up by the other animals. They lay eggs in such a place where they are least likely to be eaten by the other place. This type, they are protect the animals eggs, their eggs. One is animal protect their eggs from being eaten by other animals. Well, second point is they protect their newly hatched young ones for the same reason. Newly hatched eggs no eaten by the other animals. Third one place is they lay eggs in such place where they are least likely to eaten by the other animals or insects. For example, butterfly lay their eggs on the underside of the leaves because nobody go there and nobody destroy the eggs. That place butterfly lay their eggs. For the protection of the eggs, they find a safe place to lay eggs. Cockroach lay eggs, they lay their eggs in dark place. In dark place, some animals will not go there. In dark place, nobody will go. No any insect, no other animals will go. The dark place is a safe for laying eggs. While crocodiles dig a shallow pit near a sandy river bank to lay their eggs. Look here, crocodile dig a shallow pit near sandy, and then that day they lay their eggs. Why? Because to protect them eggs, protect their eggs by eaten by other animals. Understood, no kids? Now, animals that give birth to their young ones. Animals, now we are going to see animals that give birth to their young ones. Animals that give birth to young one are called the mammals or viviparous. Animals that give birth to young ones means same kind of animal that are called mammals or viviparous. The young ones develop inside the female animal's body and are delivered once the full term is over. The young ones develop inside the female animal's body that deliver once the full term is over. In term wise, if the term is over, there the time over to give the female animal give birth to the young ones. Mammals have hair on their body. Significant of the mammals is mammals have hair on their body. They have mammary gland that produce milk in the females. Mammals have hair on their body, and the mammals have mammary glands. Mammary glands to produce a milk for in the females. The mother feeds this milk to the newborn. The milk produced in female womb, that milk is feed this milk to the newly born baby. Dog, for example, dogs, wallabies, elephants, and human being are some example of mammals. These are the example of mammals are dog, cat, wally, elephant, tiger, cow, buffalo, and human beings. They are give direct birth to their young ones. Understood, no? Next, how they take care of their young ones? Animals, how take care there of their young ones? Animals take care of their young ones for a brief period after their birth. Animal take care of their young ones means their baby brief time. Brief time means long time. Mammals feed their young ones their own milk. When the baby will born, that time mammal feed their milk to that one baby. Birds to bring bit of food and keep feeding their young ones. Birds also to bring a bits of food and feed them. They also stay around their nests to protect their babies from other animal that may want to hunt them. The parents stay there to protect their babies from the other animals that may hunt the babies. How the animals save their eggs, that type mammals also protect their babies from the hunt guards, means who will hunt them. Understood, no? Next, in this one picture, see kids, bird is feeding its babies. Kangaroo and his its baby, elephant baby. Look in this one, wally and its baby, cow and its has baby, means they give direct to their young one birth. But here bird is lay eggs in nest, but it is the picture of the feeding the food. Here are some example of love and bonding between the animals and their young ones. It is the bonding. Examples are the bonding between the baby and the animals and their babies, means young ones. The mother cow feed its young calf immediately after CQ birth. The mother cow, means the cow, feed its baby. Baby is called as a calf immediately after CQ's birth. When the cow give birth to the young ones, no, that time after some time it feed its baby a milk. Okay, means it feed it. What it will feed? It feed the milk. Baby dolphin stay close to their mother for up to 5 years. The baby dolphin stay with his mother, stay close to their mother up to 5 years. Kangaroo carry their young ones in their pouch from birth right to up to the time to the cannot fit into it. Kangaroo carry their young ones in their pouch from birth right up to time to the cannot eat into. Look here in this one, how the kangaroo put his baby in pouch and walk. That type cow also feed its baby after giving birth some time. And this one dolphin, baby stay with its mother up to 5 years. Elephants stay in their herd to protect their young ones or calves. Animals, look here in this picture, animals stay in group to protect their young ones. Animals stay their herd, stay there in group to protect their young ones. Birds feed their young ones until they cannot fly out of the nest to find their own food. Birds feed their baby, feed their young ones until they cannot fly out of the nest to find their own food. Look in this, how the bird feeding its baby. Understood, no? In this picture, the cow feed its baby after giving birth to within a few hours. Kangaroo keep its baby in its pouch. Understood, no? And elephants are in group to protect their babies. Elephants are there in a herd to protect their young ones, calves. Now we are going to see the words to know. Reproduction, we learned in lesson. Reproduction means the process of creating young ones of own kind. Young ones of own kind means elephant give birth to elephant, cow give birth to the cow. Yes or no? Dog give birth to the dog. Dog means puppy. Elephant give birth to the young ones, calves. Cow give birth to this one small baby. Is there no? This type bird give birth to small birds. Okay. This one reproduction. Reproduction is the process of creating another of one's kind. One's kind, okay? Another own kind, the one's kind. Hatching. What is hatching? Fully developed chicks breaking the egg cell and coming out. Fully developed egg chicks break out the egg cell and come out. It's called the hatching. Amphibians. Animals that are able to live on land and as well as in water. They are called the amphibians. Cocoon. An envelope spun by the larvae of many insects. They are called the cocoon. Pupa. A stage in an insect's life cycle when the larva build a cocoon around it. Pupa is a stage in an insect's life cycle when the larva build a cocoon around it. Okay. Oviparous. Egg laying animals are called oviparous. Now viviparous. Animal that give birth to young ones. Animal that give birth to their young ones. Spawn. Spawn means the mass of small eggs laid by the animals like this fish or frog. Look here in this picture, kids. It is there. Spawns. Okay? And here, look here. What is this? Cocoon. Larva. Young ones, spawns, group of small eggs is called the spawns. Next. Spawns, the mass of the small eggs laid by the animals like fish and frog. Embryo. Unborn developing baby is called embryo. Unborn developing baby is called embryo. Molting. The shedding of old skin. Molting means the shedding of old skin. in this picture, life cycle of cockroach, it is called the moulting. Shedding of the old skin is called the moulting. It is a white, then it is converted into brown in color. Okay. Nymphs, the baby cockroach that hatch to the young ones. Nymphs means the baby cockroach that hatch out of the eggs. Mammals, animals giving birth to young ones directly. Mammals means animals give birth to their young ones directly. It comes into viviparous. Understood now? Viviparous are animals that give birth to their young ones. Next, we are going to revise the same lesson. Okay, it's a revision time, short time is there. We are going to revise the same lesson. Okay, here all animals reproduce there either by laying eggs or by giving birth to their young ones. Yes, some animals lay eggs and some animals give by direct birth to their young ones. 2. The life cycle of an animal include key stages of development from birth to the adult stage. Yeah, life cycle of the animals, insects include the key stages of development from birth to their young ones. 3. Egg-laying animals are called oviparous. Egg-laying animals are called oviparous, and those give birth to their young ones are called viviparous. Birds, insects, reptiles, and amphibians reproduce mostly in laying eggs. Yeah, birds, insects, reptile, amphibians, mostly they are reproduced by laying eggs. Frogs and salamanders are amphibians that reproduce by laying eggs. Yeah, amphibians they are called because they are living land, live on land and in water both. 6. Cockroaches have 3 stages in its life cycle. Yeah, cockroach have, butterflies have 3-4, other animals, insects have 3-4-5 stages, but only one cockroach has 3 stages in its life cycle, namely the egg, nymph and the white butterfly have the nymph and adult. One is egg, nymph and adult, while butterflies have 4 stages, egg, larva, pupa and adult. Mammals give direct birth to their young ones and feed them their own milk. Yeah, almost all mammals give birth to their direct young ones and they feed their own milk to their young ones, means their baby. Understood now? They feed them their own milk. Newly born baby means young ones. Mammals feed them their own milk. Okay, kids. Now we are going to see the exercise. Before going to see the exercise, we should read the lesson carefully and try to find out the fill in the blanks, name the following, explain the sentences, answer the following. We should solve this one, no? Then how will solve this one without reading the lesson? Is it possible? No. So first of all, you watch the video and read the lesson carefully and write down new words and learn that one. Understood, no, kids? In the next video, we are going to solve the exercise. Until you read the lesson, find out the difficult words, new words. Okay? Thank you for watching this video, kids.